And what's in been doctor's bag? Too many things, that can be kept. But normally, I would keep my stethoscope. I'll keep a torch. I'll keep my writing pad. I'll keep some basic dressing material. I'll keep some tapes, medical tapes, and all. And gloves, of course, because you may need to touch patients. And if there is a special requirement, like someone wanting to have an enema, someone wanting to change a RILS tube, then I will, in special, after talking to patient, I'll arrange those things and take with me for visits. Many times, it will be helpful to have a nebulizer with you, if in case patient do not have, and patient is having breathing discomfort, maybe help through nebulizer. Nowadays, very useful. Small devices for ECGs also have come. So, you can also think of carrying them. And simple medications for pain, vomiting, gastritis, and all, pantoprazole, MCT, drotin injections will be sufficient to keep for to handle the painful situations or situations like vomiting, fever, and all. Normally, I do not carry any medicines, dispensing medicine for patients, because I expect them to buy and arrange by themselves from pharmacy. If there is some emergency, I can give some, couple of doses, but that is not routinely I keep in my bag or on my kit. So you can see thermometer, stethoscope, and pulse oximeter is very useful these days. Other than that, otoscope, ophthalmoscope, spirometry, peak flow meter, sorry. And blood pressure. So you can see the list: stethoscope, BP instrument, thermometer, gloves, jelly, tissue, torch, otoscope, ophthalmoscope, tongue depressor, peak flow meter, pulse oximeter. But essentially, I would say stethoscope, thermometer, BP instrument, gloves, torch, otoscope, and ophthalmoscope I do not keep normally for home visits, because I feel in our practices of limited use. Tongue depressor many times may be useful, but torch light is good enough. Peak flow meter, if somebody is breathless, then it's obvious. So peak flow meter is normally I do not carry. Pulse oximeter is of course important these days because of COVID infection, as well as other even respiratory distress situation. We can judge whether to treat or to refer the patient. So these are the important instruments we should keep when we visit. So there are a few other things like urine dipsticks, swabs. These are the ideal things which is mentioned in the textbook. So the only textbook which will have a chapter on home visit, what should be in doctor's bag, is Oxford textbook of general practice. You will not find this chapter in any other book. Swabs, stethoscope for fetus, fetal examination, specimen container, patella hammer, speculums, and glucometer. Glucometer is also a useful device, because I made a couple of visits where patients were, I was, because it sometimes you cannot refuse. So I went to see patient. Patient was unconscious and was in hypoglycemia, and just by treating with oral glucose, she became all right. So it is important to use and have glucometer also. So blood, so pulse oximeter, glucometer, BP instrument, thermometer, stethoscope, and writing pad and torch. These are the important ones I would consider useful when you make a home visit. But these are all extensive things. Depending upon the population you are serving, it is useful to keep them also comprehensively. As the time has changed, you can see mobile telephone charger, control drug record books. If you are giving someone morphine or something like that, if you are taking care of palliative care, then you have to keep your stamp also. And prescribing narcotics has a special form, and you can do that, but you must be carrying your prescribed form as well as your medical stamp. It is useful to carry your medical stamp, also your visiting card, because people may ask you for your visiting card also, and sometimes it is embarrassing that you are not carrying your visiting card. So local map nowadays, GPS is of course it helps us. Google, you can Google any site and you get it. So these are some other equipments or requirements that are useful. You know, keeping your mobile charged, having extra charger, having extra battery. These are all helpful when you're in yourself providing care, and not having enough, battery in your mobile is a bad situation for a doctor, especially when you are visiting a patient's home. So this also says Oxford Handbook of General Practice, British Formulary, obstetric calculators, peak flow meter chart, and book for keeping a record of patients and counters. So whatever prescription I write, I will scan in my Adobe scanner, and it is automatically saved through my email ID. So I keep record of all my home visits, all my patients. Nowadays I'm using electronic prescriptions, but even if I do a handwritten note, I make a point that I scan it by myself or through my staff and keep it on record for the patients if required for future. There are some other equipments, spacers, cannulas, nebulizer machines, AED, automated external defibrillator, space device, needles, syringes, bandages. Among these, I would say bandages most important. Sometimes you may need to give IV glucose for hypoglycemic patients. At times it is difficult to find veins, so better use IM injections. If it is emergency, better to refer to hospitals and simply tell patients how serious a patient and cannot be handled at home, and give the best advice which is required for the patient. These are some other things: swabs, adhesive, plasters, scissors. So this is a comprehensive list: antiseptic sachets, dressing pack, sharp box. So normally I do not carry, but if you are, focusing on home visit or home care, it is important that you organize all these things in your bag or in your, in your kit, home visit kit, or like you have emergency trolleys in hospital. Similarly, you should have a home visit kit or bag or suitcase, whatever. And there are some certain drugs which are been recommended. This is the textbook recommendation. So you can see all this: lorazepam, ciprofloxacin, local anesthesia, morphine, thrombolytic therapy. These are foremost advanced things, but mostly I would not prefer to use thrombolytic therapy. Even not carry morphine, I would rather ask and give prescription of morphine to patient if required. Adrenaline may be sometimes life-saving if you inject something. Even I've seen severe anaphylactic reaction with diclofenac, Dynapar injection IM. In those situations, it is useful to carry some adrenaline if possible. But otherwise, I would won't say that these injections are antibiotics all are required in our kind of practice. Antiemetics are very important. Antiallergics are very important. Hydrocortisone is very important. Diuretics you may need for accelerated hypertensive situations. Patients having high BP, then giving a bit of IV diuretic or oral diuretic may be useful. Glucagon and IV glucose, as I said, is useful, but you should be ready mentally and skill-wise to provide those things. Tranquilizer I would do not generally carry, but I would prescribe on my pad and ask patient to administer or refer to hospital. Antacid, oral drugs. So as I said, normally I do not carry pharmacy in my bag, and I will advise patients to bring, if it is not an emergency, antibiotics, antacids, antihistaminics, ORS, aspirin, and all. Aspirin, clopidogrel, of course you can keep. If you have, there are small ECG devices nowadays. If it is MI, it is useful to give aspirin, clopidogrel. Prednisolone, It's not necessarily, but non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs sometimes may be useful. Diclofenac suppositories. So these are all textbook recommendations a doctor should keep.